All right, so this is the final product. It looks so good. Look at my little table, I love it. And then we got some bins on the bottom.
I was gonna make you a little chair.
It looks so good. All right, good morning, guys. So it's Saturday and I'm here with my boyfriend and he's gonna help me build some what would you call it, like some clothing hangers made out of wood for my storage unit, because I just got a storage unit. And I'll insert a picture of the inspiration right here of what it is we are trying to accomplish. So he's gonna put that all on the perimeter of the storage garage. And I did rent a storage garage. It's a 10 by 20. It's air conditioned, it's a drive up, and it's 2 minutes away from my house. So that's really nice because it's literally right down the street. I would have gotten a garage in the community, but the garage in the community doesn't have air conditioning and they're all taken. So I decided to go to the storage unit that's literally across the street from our house. And that way it's a really short drive and I can have my office back and be able to work properly and take pictures properly. And it'll just make me a lot happier. So I'll be more motivated to work inside my office versus working on the couch or working in the
show them what you see in Florida.
In all the places. In all the places in the house. So I work better like when things are nicely set up versus like all cluttered and a mess. But I used to have an office, but offices are kind of a waste of money. They're too expensive. Really, they're way too expensive. So I just rather have like a storage garage and still have my office inside the house. I like working from the house, so it's all working out. So we just got to Home Depot and I figured I'd take you guys with us, so maybe this can give you some inspiration if you have a garage that you're using, or even if you have one inside, or whatever it is you use. These racks, my boyfriend says, are fairly easy to put together and it saves you a lot of money. So I'm gonna bring you guys along with us. We brought Bay's work truck. It's one of the ones with the really big bed, so that's kind of cool. And we are at Home Depot. I don't really like Home Depot that much. Do you? That's a dumb question. Yeah, you do. All right, so we figured out exactly what we need. So you wanna explain which one?
What?
You wanna explain which one?
What do you mean?
Which one did you end up getting?
Filmed the thing. It's a 2x4.
We ended up getting that one.
Good job.
Which size is that bin? I can't see.
It's a 2x4 that's 12 feet long.
And he's gonna cut it in half because you save a lot more money when you just cut it in half versus, you save about $10. So it's nothing crazy, but it's like lunch, so. He's just gonna cut it in half. It takes like a second to cut in half. So that's what we ended up getting. All right, so we got what we needed. That flag looks so pretty. I love that flag. It's about to storm. Gosh, I don't want the sticks to get wet. So anyway, this is it. This is the storage unit. It's air conditioned. Yeah. It's a 10, babe, it's a 10 by 20, right?
What?
It's a 10 by 20, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, a 10 by 20. Huh? Babe, really?
Okay, I don't know, babe. Let me measure.
Okay, measure it.
That's super important.
Because I feel like it doesn't look like a 10 by 20.
Feet.
You told me it was a 10 by 20.
Technically, you measure from the inside because you can't use that. Measure this way from that. By 9 feet.
They lied. They lied. What the heck is that measurement even? A 14 by 9? I've never even heard of that for a storage unit. All right, well, whatever. This is the storage unit. I pay for supposedly a 10 by 20, but you know how that works. I'm gonna look at the paperwork when I get home and then I'm gonna tell them something. Maybe it's including the driveway space.
What driveway?
They said it's a drive-up space. I feel like they would include that.
It's not a drive-up space.
All right, so we're gonna get started. I'm so excited. I mean, it's not like the nicest thing in the world. Obviously, it's a storage unit, but I mean, it works and it's air conditioned. It supposedly stays at 75. Supposedly, but again, you know how that is. So we just measured it and now we just have to cut it. See how easy this is? And it ended up saving us money. So definitely do it this way. If you have the means to cut it though, I mean. He's gonna use, what is that, babe? A sawzall? That's one to say. So, and it'll literally take a second to cut it. And we saved 10 bucks. I know it's not the craziest save in the world, but like my boyfriend reminded me, I am a thrifter. Gotta be thrifty in all aspects of life. You want me to hold it over here?
Just stand on it.
Stand where? That's gonna fall on my toe. All right, see how fast that was? And we saved again. Like, it was probably more than $10. Took under 5 minutes to do and we saved $15. I did the math. So definitely do it that way for sure. And this is the storage unit. It's a drive up, so you just drive right up, open the door, and then you come on right in. So yeah, I'm excited to move everything.
Gonna turn it around.
Yeah. Wouldn't it be uneven though to stand it on the ground?
No, because I still gotta cut that. I feel like.
All about those angles.
Is that a good width?
I think it could be a little smaller. What do you think?
Yeah.
I think that's good right there.
Is it good there?
Yeah.
You want to hold it for me?
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's pretty sturdy. Look at that. And that's only one side, so. And compared to racks that you buy in the store, it's a lot cheaper because we got like a little like shitty rolling one from, I don't know where it was from Walmart. And I don't know if you guys have seen the IKEA ones, but not that they're bad, because I'm not saying that they're bad by any means, but this is really sturdy. You're gonna be able to fit a lot of clothes and not have a fear that it's gonna collapse on you. So that's really why I like this, because we had a situation, the one in the office, that actually did collapse. And that was a pain really. And my employee could have gotten injured and that would have been a whole mess, so. This will be really good, I think. And it saves you a lot of money, because how many are we building for 25 bucks?
Three, technically.
We're building three for 25. Well, the whole total was $50, but we bought a pack of measuring tapes because we don't have one at the house.
I'm gonna do it outside so you don't have to sleep.
What is that, babe?
I'll do it here. Huh?
What are you doing?
The holes in the pot.
Oh.
Not impressed with Bosch at all. There it is. I guess we're talking shit.
Maybe we should do this outside. Look at how cool that just was. That's the hole now to put the stick. Isn't that awesome? Wow, that's so cool. Look at that, a perfect hole. Look at that. What did you use for that?
A drill, that
one. Well, what is it called?
I don't remember that.
Well, what is it called, babe? What if somebody wants to do it?
Don't embarrass me. I don't know what it's called. I forgot.
So how did you know what to get?
Because I've used it before.
Alright.
That's called a speed wave panel from Bosch.
Oh, okay. It's called a speed wave panel.
Paddle
from Bosch. And what's the size on it?
This is 1 1/4.
That's 1 1/4.
Inch.
And it'll fit the stick that we have. So look at that. A do-it-yourself little rack. Look at that. And again, just so you guys know, we are building 3 of these. Right? Are we building 3?
Yeah, whatever you want.
Well, we have enough material to build 3, but we don't know if we're going to build 3. So the build out...
Whoa. Not 3 of these. 3 full sections.
Oh, we have enough material to do 3 full sections?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Okay, so 3 material. That's a lot. And it costed $50, but that was including... a measuring tape set, which he needed for work. So if we deduct the $14 from the $50, it was about $36 for the materials. The only thing that we need is the stick, which I'm using the stick that I had at home, and the aluminum sticks. How much were they, babe? How much did those run? $9. So it's still cheaper. Housework stuff today, like that pile of laundry, cleaning the bathrooms. There's 2 more loads in the laundry right now. Really boring stuff I wish I didn't have to do, but that is life. The Christmas tree is probably not gonna come down today. In all honesty, it's just not gonna happen today. My boyfriend is at the storage unit still, and he is working on that and getting it all done. And I'm gonna go over in about an hour. I'm gonna go over and maybe do a progress shot. I know that he told me that there's some really exciting stuff that he's working on, and I'm excited to see it. I can't wait to move everything from my office and just make my office really pretty. And I'm really, really excited. So I'll check in with you guys as soon as I go to the storage unit. All right, so. We're finishing the last, well, my boyfriend says that the storage unit is done. He already created everything. And now we're taking literally a huge majority of the inventory in the bed of the pickup. Oh my God. The hoarding problems, it looks like. All that inventory.
We're off.
And the weather doesn't look that hot, but it'll be fine. It will be fine. Open up. Ow, my back. Oh, thank God we have the company truck. I'm excited to see it.
Just wood.
Babe, you don't think nothing will fly out, right?
Maybe one.
Babe, don't play. Look at that. All the clothes. Looks good. It looks like we're hoarders.
Look up front. Get the weather.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, we gotta beat the weather. All right, so we made it to the storage unit. All the clothes intact. And the weather, it looks like we're just about to beat it. It literally took us like, how long do you think it took us to get here?
1 minute, maybe.
Maybe a minute. Maybe.
Even though I cut and built all the shelves faster.
You know, I read once that somebody made a boxing ring in a storage unit. Isn't that crazy? Look at the weather. All right, the moment of truth. Dun, dun, dun. I haven't seen it yet, guys, so you're gonna see it with me for the first time. And babe, the wind is picking up. Which one's mine? It looks awesome. Oh, you didn't see the other side, babe? Oh, that's right, the bar's at the house. Oh my gosh, and look at the little table he built me. Isn't that cute? So like just in case I need to use a table. Babe, you should pick up carpentry. Look at how cool. Look at that. Babe, you're the best. Why does it feel like there's no AC in here? Do you think there's AC in here?
Yeah, but very.
They said it stays at 75. I'm paying a lot more money to have this AC'd and it doesn't feel like there's any air on. I'm gonna talk to the manager. They are not gonna take me for a ride.
Not enough falls.
All right, guys, I gotta go so I can help him put the clothes. I'll be back. All right, so we hung up a majority of the stuff. There's so much space in here. This whole side is gonna not be utilized right now, and it's just literally hanging stuff. I do still at home, I still have that whole rack full. There's still stuff that we need to bring over here, but just enough that's gonna fill up this entire rack. So I'm gonna have a whole space on this side. So this is pretty much what I had hanging in my house, and it was jam packed. Here, look how much room there is. Like, this is crazy. How much piece of stuff do you think I could fit in here, babe?
Oh, man.
Probably a few thousand, easily. So that's pretty awesome. This is excellent for growing, and I'm really excited. How I'm gonna organize it. I don't know if I'm gonna organize it today, but how I'm gonna organize it, there's gonna be thrifted items, liquidation on one side, and then the designer stuff on another side. And then things that go in the boxes are gonna be just like Christmas, summer that's waiting to be listed, shoes, all that sort of stuff. So yeah, I love it, babe. Good job. I love my table too.
It's my table now, actually.
I love it. It's so cute. I'm gonna go to Walmart and get like the little paper. What is that? Like the little paper acrylic thing. And I'm gonna put marble, like that, the vinyl marble.
I signed the table.
And he just signed the table. Put the date, babe, just so we know when you made it.
What day is it today? That's really bad.
The
14th
or the 15th? 15th. That's awesome. For not being a carpenter, I don't know. Pretty good at carpentry. But no, really, he says that anybody can do it.
Anybody can do it. You just need
You just, honestly, you need to pay attention because there's lots of power tools involved. So, you do need power tools, right?
Yeah, you need
them. What power tools do you need?
I used a very simple... I used an impact drill to fasten the fasteners. I used a just regular drill to drill these holes.
But you bought like a special piece that goes on top of it.
Yes, the paddle. It's meant for wood.
To make circles.
Circles to drill. And then I used my Makita Sawzall.
Hashtag not sponsored.
But
hashtag we wish.
Yeah, I wish. But you can use a technically a miter saw. You can use a circular saw. You can use a table saw. You can use a regular manual saw.
So overall, on expertise, how hard would you say this was?
I think a 5-year-old can probably put this together.
Babe, do you think I could have done it?
No.
Come on, yes I could have.
She can't really build anything.
Yes I can, I could build IKEA stuff.
But it falls apart.
No it doesn't, that's not true. I build IKEA stuff all the time. Not really, you build it. I try to sometimes. Yeah. So this is awesome. Thanks, babe. We have to go to Home Depot so he can get the stuff to screw this together. Then we're gonna go home, get ready for dinner. And I'm gonna stop by Goodwill. That's next to the place we're going for dinner. Yeah. Yay! I'm gonna put you to scan Amazon books. Stuff for FBA. Yeah. You can't just follow me around.
Hungry.
Well... All right, let's ride. Wow, and we beat the weather. Look at that. It, babe, look, the camera's not even picking it up like it's bad.
Zoom in. Let me see.
Let me see.
You can tell it's bad.
I don't know if you guys can tell. It's kind of a little bad. Look at the wind.
Look, compared to the tree.
Look at the wind. Yeah, that's what I'm doing. Look at the wind. Stop.
Let it focus. Don't move that much. Moving, that's why it doesn't focus.
Look at the wind. It's pretty windy. Yeah, the weather is not very good right now. So that kind of sucks. But yeah, this place is like deserted right now. I wish they could see though how gray the sky was. It's kind of scary actually. All right.
So that's the one that bites you and like really messes you up.
Look at the spider. That's a poisonous spider, you guys. Look at it. Oh my gosh. Yeah, it is a brown recluse, babe.
I think so.
That shit is so scary. We always have these. Oh, oh, get it away. Look how close we are. Eddie asked me if I could sit next to him in the truck. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, right. We have clothes. Look, but how close we are in a car. I could drive from here.
Technically.
Your steering wheel.
Don't ever put your foot on there because you
have to get it. Not. All the clothes here now. Yay, officially moved out. Woohoo! Alright, guys. So we have two sides now. Yay! Only thing missing is we just have to fasten that, but that's really easy. So, on both sides. But yeah, it's pretty much done. It looks so good. I'm so excited. You guys have no idea. Wait till I show you guys my office at home, how it looks right now. I can't wait to just organize everything and start working properly out of here. Looks really good. Babe, how much would you say it costed to build everything?
About $120, and I bought like some miscellaneous stuff.
So there you have it. This is definitely, I think, the way to go in racks, because I have a rack at home that I'm keeping at home, and it costed $50, and it only holds maybe 50 items, maybe. So that's pretty awesome. You can keep these in your house. Like, you don't have to have them in a garage or a storage unit. I just have it like that because I don't have enough room at my house. But, I mean, these are awesome. And they hold so much stuff. stuff. Awesome, awesome. I'm so excited. Oh my gosh.